What up guys, TheSighBored here. Today we are at 66 Speed Bike once again. And guess what, it's my 50,000 kilometers scheduled oil change, engine oil change, oil filter change. And we are also going to be cleaning out the air filter. I usually clean it out every 10,000 kilometers. So you are smelling the oil.
It's liquid moly. First time.
Liquid moly. Why? Why the oil looks too good, is it? Huh? So you can't believe it's liquid moly.
Yes.
Why?
Yeah, it looks good, eh? No lah, but you did dyno with this oil lah. You did. So
recently,
was the temperature raise up, no?
Of course temperature will go up.
Yeah lah, but if did the guy say anything about the temperature disturbance or nothing, it was okay lah. So what was the horsepower?
110. Mine standard, just air filter and this exhaust.
No, you have grease as well. Spark plug.
Oh, grease. Oh, I forgot all the hidden technologies,
oh,
right?
Oh, shit. But you just went recently only.
Recently, lah. I went with Joe.
Oh, yeah. You went to bike bomb set, and? Paya,
eh? Yes.
It's good.
So, today's challenge is
Not to
spill oil when you remove the oil filter. Can it be done?
Let's see.
Okay, can you tell me why they designed the oil filter up there where, you know, it's potentially gonna spill everywhere, all over the engine?
No, but you see, R6 and ZX-6, they have, is the bike that have the oil filter located at the...
Is it anything got to do with like the pressure of placement where the filter is?
No. Because you see, the oil move around with pressures inside your, you know, it's very small.
Yeah, but the oil to go through the filter at the bottom and to go through the filter at the top,
it doesn't make much difference. Personally, I would say that if the oil goes to the filter at the bottom, it's much better. Because the main purpose of a filter is to filter out, right? Even though they're located at the top here, I never think that way, lah, bro.
Yeah, I got too much free time, that's why I like to ask these weird questions.
It's good, eh? It's good. Alright, so the challenge for today is not to spill up the oil when we are removing the oil filter. A normal way of removing is basically to put it on a stand, on a pair of stand, and then we remove this. So the difference that I'm going to do is just a trial and error, eh? I'm not sure it's going to affect anything or not. But I'm going to put up on a stand, on a normal side stand, and then we're going to remove this. Okay. We're going to put it on the side stand. Right. Let's put it on the side stand. Done. Dah lah bang. Still come out lah.
Still lah?
Still.
So no Neslo for you.
You see? It's the same thing. So last time when we put it on the pedal stand, we still have this spillage. And now, we still have it. So, does it make any difference? No, we still have the amount of spill that happened again.
So why do you think they designed it like that?
You see, the pad itself is designed such so that, you know, the drain out means the spillage that will happen when you're taking out the oil filter will basically float out to the right direction.
The right direction. So
it is meant for that.
You're gonna wash it later? Please wash it later.
Yes. I will as a cleaner, so I will wash that for you. Okay, bro?
Good answer. Good answer. Why do you need to put some oil in the new oil filter before install?
Okay, the thing is like this. Gee, aku setiap kali mesti ada explanation, but it's bullshit explanation. I'm just a cleaner, bro. Again. Okay. So, kalau kau tengok, this oil filter is designed such that it is dry at this moment. Right? Some engine they have what we call as a high pressure oil pump. Tends to be that the Kawasaki, most of them has quite low oil pressure to compare with others model like R6, like Yamaha or like CBR or Honda, kan? They have higher pressure. Kawasaki, they have, if I'm not mistaken, it's like lower than 150 PSI. Lower than 150 PSI. So, with that in mind, if you have air, if you don't pour the oil inside it first, at the beginning, before you install, so this oil is doesn't have that much enough pressure to basically to push all the air. Oh,
okay.
So in the end, you have quite lengthy of time where your crankshaft, your camshaft is not lubricated.
So the air is coming out, being pushed out.
So what happened, this is real cases. So the guy went for a service. The guy, the mechanic just put on the oil filter, put on, and then he start the engine. This guy, he didn't look at the bike, just start and then he drove. And about 1,000 kilometer, freaking the crankshaft just went off. So the crankshaft was just like, you know, the bushing that around the habis. Habis bang, rosak bang. So when we look, we didn't notice this, that the cause was from the punya oil pump. So when we look back, we found out that the oil pressure was low. So there was they didn't put oil inside the oil filter. So what happened is the air was trapped.
You mean trapped for the whole 1,000 kilometers?
1,000 kilometers.
Is that bad?
It's bad, bro.
But why? So why
I will show you later on when we start the engine. I will show you it takes quite a lot of time before all the oil goes and circulated and you have enough pressure to turn off the oil pressure indicator here. There is an oil pressure indicator.
So for that example you gave, the guy's oil pressure thing should have been lighted on,
yes,
right? But he never bothered.
He never bothered. He just went off.
He thought it's normal or something.
Probably he didn't even look at that one. He just like, oh my, change my new oil. Alright, bro. Pump. 1,000 kilometer. Bam. Crankshaft habis, man.
Yeah.
Honestly. And the crankshaft was out, bro. Memang teruk, bang. Buka crankshaft baru, bang.
Okay, so we are using liquid moly yet again. Fully synthetic, and this time there is the additive, this small can of thing. So why are we using additive?
So the main purpose of the additives is basically anti-wear, anti-friction. An oil, when you use it for some time, what happen? The viscosity of the oil drops, right? For liquid moly, as you know, that liquid moly is, there are no additives inside the engine oil. So the engine oil is based on is basically from a virgin based oil. So to make it anti-wear, anti-friction, the engine oil itself is anti-wear, anti-friction, but when it's been heat up or you use it for some mileage, so the thickness of the oil drops, right? The viscosity of the oil drops. So for that, you put this oil additive to basically increase a bit of the viscosity. In this case, it's also prevent from having a kind of friction in your engine, wear and tear of your engine. It's basically prolong engine life.
Okay.
It has the apa ada punya sukatan, bahasa Inggeris apa sukatan?
Measurement.
So for each liter of oil, you put about 20 ml to 25 ml. If I'm not mistaken, it's written somewhere here.
Okay.
So we have about four. We are using more or less about 4 liters of engine oil for this bike. So basically, I'm just gonna pour
the whole can.
If you're using,
but it says there 125.
Yeah, the full amount is 125. If you want to put 100 ml, it's okay. But if you put a bit more, the only problem that you will a C is basically you will have slips on your clutch plate.
Oh, okay.
But
so too much is also not good.
It's also not good because it's anti-wear, anti-friction.
Okay.
So when you put too much, then you will have slips. But for a let's say if you're using your engine oil is just 1 liter and you put the whole can, then you will have this problem.
Okay.
But if you put it on a 4 liters engine oil, okay. I don't see that this is a big difference. But anyway, as recommended, you have to put it 25 ml per liter.
So not having it is also not to say it's end of the world. Still, yeah. Everything runs like normal.
Correct.
But adding it will give better protection against friction and wear.
Correct.
Right, so let's do it. So you're putting it all because we are putting all the full amount.
Okay, if you see, we will put the amount of the fresh engine oil first.
Okay.
Later on, we'll have the what we call as the remaining,
yeah. Yeah.
So that basically more or less, you will see how you're gonna do.
Okay.
So you can use this remaining for your top ups, and also you can put it on your next service. You can put it add up on your next service as well.
So this one will be the last one going.
The last one going in.
I got that one.
Alright. So for the user, most of the time what we have to look when we just did our service. So when the guy start up the bike, so if you notice here, there is what we call it as a teko. Teko dalam bahasa Inggeris apa?
Teko lah.
Teko.
Teko is the one make the T one.
So you have this T sign here, you see?
Oh.
So this sign show you that there is no pressure on your oil sensor.
Okay.
Oil pressure sensor.
Okay.
So when you start up your bike, this pressure, this sensor should go off after like 4 or 5 seconds on your first initial after you just did your fresh engine oil change.
Okay.
But after you run it for several times, then this will go off as soon as you start up the engine. Okay. Right? So what happened if you start it up for let's say 5 or 7 seconds and it's still on? You turn off your engine, you turn on again, and you start it again. And you monitor for the second time. If it's still there, then you have to push the air out from your oil filter. Alright, so let's do it. That's what happened. So when the guy did the fresh, if you notice just now, when we did about 5 seconds, the sensor went off, right? So now it's already off. So if you notice now, there will be a difference where when you start up, immediately after you start your engine, this sensor will be turned off, right? So let's look. Okay. So what we have to do? Every time when we do an engine oil service or we change with the new oil, we have to look this. We have to ensure that the mechanic also know this. Because when you have this blinking, the teko blinking, the oil pressure is not enough inside your engine, in your system. So what this will affect is basically affecting the whole lubrication system. So if you notice, when I put the oil inside the oil filter, it reduces the time where the oil goes to the pressure sensor. Without doing this, I have noticed and I have witnessed myself, we have a lot of trouble where we have to open up the engine oil, I mean the oil filter, to push off the air out of your oil filter. It's not end of your engine, but make sure that you don't run your engine with this sensor or warning on.
So that's the function of lubricating the or filling oil in the oil filter.
Correct.
Before you install.
Correct. So basically you reduce the amount of air inside your air filter. Because if you have too much of air, and Kawasaki is well known with low pressure oil
still pump, okay.
It's still okay, but you have to basically, when you see that it doesn't went off, you have to purge off the air. And you will have small amount of leakage or spillage lah, eh. So do this and you don't have hassle. Tapi ini pun aku dah masuk dalam botol yang ketiga tadi.
Okay, so this is the additive added into the with the oil.
Yeah.
So it looks like black.
Black, that color kan.
Gaya mutu keunggulan lah.
That right bro. So we put this. Now we look at the window kan. So when you fill up your engine oil, you have to make sure that the engine the oil level go to the highest point to the highest mark. Don't leave it at the lower mark. Alright? Somewhere in the middle or to the highest, right? But our recommendation or practice here is we'll fill it up until it goes to the top, right? Okay. Yes, ni dah penuh dah. Dah ngam-ngam lah. So, aku kasi lebih sikit.
But you can go over the limit. It's
okay.
It's fine, right?
Yeah. So, if you go over the limit, what will happen? So, you have a hose inside the engine on the top side of the engine where we call it as the overflow. If you fill up above the line, so what happened, all this excess oil will just go to your overflow. You're not gonna have sometimes people will say, hey bro, kobo ni motor jadi berat lah, it's gonna be freaking heavy lah bro. Of course the bike is 150 kilo, almost 200 kilo bro. You see, it is heavy, but that amount 200 ml is not gonna affect your engine. It's not gonna, you're not racing anyway, you're using it daily, you won't feel that much lah, yeah. But for me, it's better to put it on the higher side rather than lower side. If it lower, then you will have insufficient oil, which in result probably will have an engine problem. Result in engine problem, man. Abang nak ganti sekarang? Nak ganti sekarang ke apa?
Ambil. Dah nak sampai.
Okay. Abang parking motor sekejap. Ini adalah airbox. This is an airbox. The main the main purpose of an airbox is basically to contain the air that been sucked from your front end to go to your combustion chamber. So if let's say you don't use an airbox, what happen? The air that been sucked into your venturi here is going to be all over from your body section. So you might drain some particles or some debris out of from your engine here, engine side here, right? So we use an airbox, which is a contained airbox. So you make sure, you ensure that only clean air that been sucked into your body or to your combustion chamber. So what is the main purpose of an air filter? It's of course to filter all the air, because the air contains debris. As you roll down the road, the air contains debris, some dust, some animals, some flying, some insects, right? So the main purpose of the air filter is to filter, right? So if you look here, this is a type wear and aftermarket air filter. An aftermarket air filter will have a better air velocity that goes into your venturi here, into your throttle body, right? A normal air filter won't have this kind of look. Right, it's more compact and most of the time it's just using fiber. If you look here, you can find out that they have this like metal shield here. What we call it? Apa kita panggil?
Netting.
Shield. It's like Iron Man. Okay. So what this things does is basically give you a better airflow rate to compare with the standard one. At the same time, is to prevent larger particles that can penetrate, so it doesn't penetrate then goes into your venturi here. Okay. Right? So let's open up and see how this air filter looks like now. Aha! Whew. Damn man, look like shit though.
So what's going on? And
so, if you look here, as we spoke just now, the main purpose of an air filter is to filter all kind of debris that been sucked into your along with your air, right? So this is, see this? You have the sand, right? This is the sand that come out
as you write down, you wrote down your vehicle, it's come with the air that been sucked in. Sometimes you will see there's like ants, some insect inside here as well. If you look here, this is all where the particles that been. So this basically to show you that this air filter has done his job quite well. So he has basically filtered quite a lot of debris. So for me, it's one of a good way to show that a good filter that's working fine, as it's supposed to do.
So to maintain the air filter?
So to maintain the, okay, why we always change to a aftermarket air filter? So that you can able to wash it. Okay, as a normal air filter, a standard air filter, if you have this kind of situation, you have to change with the new one. You are unable to clean it, you are unable to wash it. But the aftermarket air filter, you are able to clean it and wash it. So you can use it many times as possible. So that's what we're going to do next, is to clean up this area and section, and we're going to put it back.
So the purpose for newspaper?
Because I'm going to clean this area. Right? So okay. I don't want, because if you look, if I take off this one, and you take off this one, normally the throttle body is look like this. So yes. If I clean this, all this debris will go to your throttle body. To so avoid that.
Bad. So that's bad, right?
Yes. So for that, I'm putting up this paper. Right? I'm putting up this paper. So that is cover my
it's called venturi again.
So now we're gonna clean up the air filter, right? So how is the process of cleaning up? How the way to clean up? First, you blow all the dust or all the debris that you have on your air filter. Take it from a distance. Don't put it directly on top of your filter, right? But keep some distance. So next, we rinse it with water just to soak it, right?
Also, don't direct cut, yep. So no water pressure type, yes. Of
just a spray, normal spray lah. Don't use high water jet or something to clean it up. You will basically damage it, right? Yes, alright. Then we're gonna take the kit and clean up. So next, we clean up the air filter using the K&N air filter cleaner, right? How to use it is basically just spray it onto your air filter.
K&N filter, but basically you can use it on, I mean this thing, you can use it on any air filter.
As long as it's a cleaner, you can use it for any air filter.
Okay.
But I'm using K&N cleaner here. Alright. Okay. Will shine like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond.
So you just apply the cleaner, no need to
do anything.
Put sponge, no need to touch anything.
If you see, right? See? You can see that it's clean.
It's becoming like no more the black.
Yes.
Black anymore.
Basically, the cleaner contains like a degreaser lah,
okay.
What I believe lah. So what it does is basically remove all the oil that you have onto your air filter.
So still, we need to reapply that oil, right?
Yeah, we have the oil as well. We have to reapply it, right? So next is we're gonna clean up the airbox, right? To clean up the airbox, you just basically push off your air. You have to clean this.
All this sponge, what's the function?
I don't know.
So is it advisable to replace, to reline it, or just
no? Just normally, if you worn out, then you just remove it.
Nobody reapplies it.
Because ZX-10R don't have this sponge.
Will that equal to more airflow?
No.
More air in the box.
Thing is, the purpose is to basically ensure you trap more debris.
Oh,
to reduce like the velocity
like
la,
or like a dirt trap,
yeah, kind of thing. I'm not sure. I'm just Never use imitation or locals, or cheap air filter. We have basically encountered some names or quite branded air filter.
But imitation.
Imitation. It's imitated because, of course, they only imitate the high quality material. Right. So they imitate and find out that the air filter got broken. Alright, so you know the glue which is basically holding up the netting is got broken to small pieces like brittles.
Okay.
So in doubt, it's basically went into the
throttle body.
Throttle body and some of it causing valve worn out. So be careful on selecting your pumps. Alright, so if you look now, you can see that it's much better and there is no more dust, it's clear without any debris, without any oil. Alright, so it looks better and excellent. We can install this to the bike. But before that, we have to put some oil. Alright,
what is the function of the oil?
It's just to prevent the air filter from getting too much from getting it dry. Okay, so when you put the oil, what happened when you have a dry filter? If you see inside here, it's basically created from I think it's carbon. I'm not sure, fiberglass or something, carbon fiber. I think so. I'm not sure what is the material made of. But anyway, when it's too dry, so it will start to break. Easy to break. So you put the oil to make sure it's well lubricated lah. So we use a special air filter oil. Alright, so this is, if you see here, it will probably tell you here. I didn't tell anything here. Whatever. So he said, do not smoke while using this. Alright? I'm not smoking.
Thanks for the info.
Alright, where we have to put, which direction we should put this oil, alright? For
yeah,
my
which direction.
Practice, right?
Yeah, which direction.
So we have what we call as the intake and outlet.
Okay.
So your air will be sucked through the intake, which is here.
Yep.
It goes out from this side. Mm-hmm. So for me, my practice, I always put it from the intake side.
Intake.
Right. So the way to put it, you just basically go through the line like this.
To draw according, following the lines.
Yes, just follow the line. Follow the line. Like this.
Is it in the top area or the...
Yeah, just on the top area
on
because
the top.
It will soak all the way to the bottom.
Okay.
If you look now, the oil has spread all over the fiber. See? You just put on top, that's it. Enough. More than enough. So when you start your engine, later on, all this oil will go all over the place. So you don't need to worry that, oh, if I put here, when you put it here, then it will be splashed out, right? But if you put it from this direction, basically it will be
put it downwards.
Yeah, it will be soaking to the, you know,
the outtake part.
Yeah.
Output part. Okay.
Yeah. That's it.
Next step?
Next step, install.
Put it back in.
The reverse of it. Put back the seal so you have a better vacuum effect, right? Put back the seal in order. See it, bang? Boleh, sana. Put it back. Alright, install the. No, you have to remove this.
Luckily, you remember.
Of course, bro.
What will happen if you forgot?
I don't think you will be able to start your engine.
Because the butterfly cannot move, right?
One, butterfly will not be able to move. Second, you will basically restrict the airflow. So, at the same time, it's better to clean up any degrees that you might have. Don't push it this way pula. Kalau kau buka ni, bermakna kau open lah kan? So, make sure. Clean it. Open other part. Same thing. So the last one. First, you might be able to open it. Okay. Do next. Okay. Open it well. Do not bleed your throttle. Alright. Check your throttle, nice and even, goes all the way down. That means that the valve was open.
You mean when the sound different means the valve is open? Yeah, you see.
Alright. Alright, bye. Pergi sekali bang, pergi sekali. Cancel. You have to cancel
I will just crop lah.
Okay. Alright guys, here again with me, Ahmad, the cleaner. So, pretty much we have done the service for 50,000 km for this bike. What we have done today is basically we have changed the engine oil, we have changed the oil filter. We have also cleaned up the air filter. Aftermarket air filter which is fitted to this ZX-6R, sorry, and we also have basically adjust the slack or the free play on the chain, the drive chain that we have on the ZX-6R. Pretty much after all this has been done, the bike has been running for 50,000 km and is still running good. Alright, I think that's it. What else?
The sprocket and chain.
What
do you think of the condition?
I think for the next service, you have to change your sprocket. This is due to when we roll up the rear tire, we can see a lot of movement on the chain. The chain start to move a lot up and down, right? So that's mean that the chain has tends to go, basically all the O-rings located on the chain start to go off. We have checked the chains and the sprocket condition. The sprocket condition has a bit worn out as well. So I think the next service, which is 55,000 km, we have to change this together with the engine oil replacement. Alright, thank you.
Sapu sana, sapu.